Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So I've got a special guest with me today. This is Atousa.
Hi.
You may have seen her YouTube videos. She's also on her career of medicine at the moment, mm-hmm. but we're on two different points of our journey. So we thought we'd get together and have a good chat about things and just let you in on our little conversation.
Yeah.
So hello and welcome to my channel.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for coming. Just a little bit introduction of you, what part of the UK you're from, what you've done, that sort of stuff.
Okay, so as Esby said, so we're kind of on a similar path, but I'm like a few years behind. So I started off my journey, I guess, by studying biomedical sciences, and I studied that at Newcastle. And then after that, I came to London at King's to study translational cancer medicine, which is like an MRes, and it was like a research master's for a year. And then I think I always came to like this field, I guess, with the intention of doing research. My plan was always to go into science, do a PhD, because it's just something I'm passionate about. And we'll get into that because I know Esky has some very strong views about that. but then when I was doing my master's, I was working with an oncologist. And what that meant was that I got to go to MDMs and I got to see patients. And, you know, you kind of interact with the people who you're doing the research for and who are kind enough to give you blood samples and stuff. And I kind of just fell in love with it. And I thought, like, I love research, but the interaction you get with patients, you get to work as a big team. Mm. And I was sold, basically. And so then I started my application process towards medicine, and it took me 2 years. I think first time I had a bit of an issue with my application, and the second time round I got accepted. And
congrats.
Thank you. It's like, it's very recent, so it was literally like 2 weeks or so ago that I got like my acceptance.
It's such a huge weight off your shoulders. Anyone applying will know.
Yeah, well, exactly. Done. Thank you. And yeah, I'm sure a lot of you guys must have heard back too as well. So so we're starting this little journey now, and I'm asking Esky for advice on like what to expect. So yeah.
You'll be fine. You'll be absolutely fine. Obviously, you're like so much more academic than me. You've done your master's degree and everything. As you said, we have like completely different views on research, because anyone who's watched my videos before will know that I hated my dissertation and my time in the lab. Mm-hmm. So what is it about research for you that makes it so interesting and that you want it? Because everyone knows that I did biomedical sciences because I got rejected for medicine. Mm-hmm. But obviously with you, the story is different. You actually wanted to do biomedical sciences.
Yeah.
So tell me a bit about what specifically about research that makes you excited.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I think I just find it interesting. That's such a boring answer. But like, whenever I read a new drug that has come out or something and it's like having such a big effect on patients, my mind thinks, oh my God, like, who created this? Like, that's amazing. And to give you an example, my supervisor who I work with now, who is a scientist and also an oncologist, when I asked her what got her to go into research, because obviously she treated cancer patients, she said when Herceptin came out, and that is a like kind of like a revolutionary drug used to treat breast cancer. Mm. She said she was kind of young, like a young doctor when that came out, and she was like amazed that this drug can have such a big effect on the patients that she was seeing. And hey, wouldn't it be amazing if I one day contributed to a drug that can have the same effect? And I think that's how I see it. And I love the like patient side of things, but I think for me it's also good to be like, well, I'd like to like leave something behind, if that makes sense. So that's sort of my view on that. But there are plenty of downsides with research and plenty of frustrations. So I get it. You're like, your views are completely justified. I get it. I'm like so frustrated like most of the time. Yeah. So
yeah, we don't want to like be putting anyone off research. Obviously, good experiences and bad experiences in the same room. So
exactly.
Yeah, I think it's just about your outlook, which is sounds good.
Yeah, definitely.
So now you've applied for graduate entry medicine.
Yeah.
And you've got a place. Well done.
Yeah.
Do you want to talk about your experiences, in particular just getting really real about rejection, how that made you feel, how you kept yourself motivated, how you kept going, and you know, that sort of stuff?
Okay, so anybody who has applied to medicine and has been unsuccessful, or has just applied to medicine in general, you know that it's very personal. Mm. And when you get rejections, when even like sometimes when if you ask somebody to read your personal statement and they might not like what you've put in or something, again, it feels very personal. Mm. And the first time I applied to medicine, like my UK CATs and BMATs, which are the two exams I took, on both occasions they weren't great. So automatically I felt like, oh well, you know, I can do research, but I feel like a failure at this exam that a lot of people who are, I guess, more fresh-faced, if you like, can get these amazing results. And I just felt like, I can't do this, and what is it? Am I never going to be a good doctor or whatever? So you have all of these doubts. And also, the first time I applied, I made a huge mistake. So I didn't know, if any of you guys have seen my other videos, you'll know I made a big video talking about all the mistakes I made. And obviously the biggest one was that I thought the application process was like a job application or like a master's application, which is what I've been used to. And I thought that you send in your reference after you've been shortlisted. No, turns out that's not how it works. And I got put back a year. And
at least that was the reason you got rejected, not because like you weren't good enough.
But the thing is, like, I don't know if that makes it worse, because you know that there are certain people who like don't try because they think, okay, well, if I don't try, I won't fail. I think what helped me get over that failure, and also, so I have been accepted onto a course, but I didn't get any interviews from anywhere else. I got 3 rejections, 1 interview, 1 place. Mm-hmm. And I think the way that I dealt with all of that failure is to take responsibility. I think, especially with the first one, I think it's so easy to be like, and you hear this a lot, and I completely understand. And I know I mention it sometimes, but a lot of people are things like, oh, the medical application process is stupid, or like the UK CAT is stupid and the BMAT is stupid. And like, yeah, I agree. Like, I genuinely think that there are better ways to assess candidates. And we were talking about this earlier, that just because there is no correlation between your entrance exam scores and how well you do and how good of a doctor you can be. So that's one way to externalize it and say, it's their fault, this is why I'm not getting in. I decided to take responsibility and think, you know what? I failed, I didn't work hard enough. Or I didn't find an efficient strategy, or I messed up. And that's hard. But the good thing about taking responsibility is that you at least feel like you can make a change. Because I feel like if you just blame the system or blame everything else, then you feel like you're completely powerless. And obviously I did do crap in my entrance exams, but on the contrary, I applied to Birmingham, which although it was like very competitive, they didn't have an entrance score. So at least I felt like, okay, well, one of my options I can kind of take responsibility for. And yeah, so it sucks. It sucks. It sucks so bad. But for me, that was the most effective way of coping with it, I think.
I think that's really good advice. I don't think I thought of that. Yeah, taking responsibility and not blaming the system. And that's the only way then you can make a positive difference with your next application if you want to do one. That's
exactly
really good.
And like a lot of the times though, like we've said this, so many people say it, a lot of the times it's not your fault. You may come from like a background or something where you don't have access to work experience, you don't have access,
it's
whereas
hard,
other people
it?
Do. Yeah, it's not fair. It's not a fair system ultimately. And I know that they put a lot of measures in place, but that's the only thing so far that makes me feel like if I take responsibility, at least I'm responsible for myself, and that's it. I can't help everything. I can't help the other things.
Great advice, thanks. So you've been, you finished your master's degree and you've been working as a research assistant at King's College. How are you preparing yourself to being a university student all over again?
Oh, excellent question. So I went out for my, like, my friend's birthday last week and it was so much fun. And I think I had like a few drinks because let's be honest, university students are notorious for drinking. And the next day, guys, I'm 25 and I was like, oh, I'm so hungover. Like, how can I cope with this? No, but like on a, I guess, an academic way, I guess what you're asking. I don't know. I'm trying not to over prepare. Obviously, I've spoken to people and they've sent me like resources to, you know, maybe have a look at anatomy if you like, and maybe that's something I can do. But a lot of other people have also said, and I'd like to know your opinion on this, they say that it's going to be hectic when you get there, and so just kind of enjoy your time and do all of the things that you might not have time to do when you start medicine. So I'm kind of taking both approaches of talking to people, getting an understanding, but also not like kind of starting my course now, essentially 6 months earlier.
Yeah, so. I think whoever gave you that advice is absolutely right.
Yeah.
So when I was like applying, I think the first month before medicine, I was like, oh, let me do a bit of reading. I was so stupid. I was like emailing and be like, can you give me your reading list?
No way.
And now I look back, I'm like, just enjoy your freaking time. Yeah. Your days off, just enjoy it. And when you come around to your lectures, you'll do it anyway.
Yeah, so, the thing is I fall into that because there's a part of me that is like a bit anxious and there's a part of me that's excited and I'm like, I want to get started now. But as a lot of people who've just started will tell you, it's going to become your life. So
exactly, with medicine it's like it's a marathon. You just have to pace yourself from the beginning and just work consistently. And I'm sure, like, because of your previous experiences with university, you know exactly how to study and what to do, and you've got loads of videos on that
kind of I feel like it's a process. I feel like you always have to optimize your studying, but and I'm sure that will change when you do medicine because there's so much content, isn't it?
There's
a lot of content.
But the thing is, the content is because you've done biomedical sciences, the content will be easy to digest. It's just the volume that's difficult.
Okay. Yeah.
But Atousa's got loads of studying skills and that sort of videos on her channel, so she's a pro, so you can go and watch that.
Pro, God. Don't quote her.
So our last question of the day. So obviously you're on your journey with medicine and you've got this great background of research and ultimately you want to merge the two. But what would be a summary of what type of doctor you want to be?
Do you mean in terms of like characteristics or as in the specialty?
Both. So like, you know, some people are like, I'm really strict and to the point and I'll just, you know, I don't know.
I think I understand your question. I mean, again, we were having a little bit of a chat before this, and I think you can never choose your specialty before you go into medicine, and I think sometimes it might be naive to say, this is what I want to do before you actually know, so that's my disclaimer.
Yeah.
But because I like research, and oncology in cancer research like goes so well, hand in hand, that's obviously an area that I'm attracted to. And I think because of that, I think you said it really nicely, like being a doctor isn't a race, it's a marathon, but I think that especially applies to a specialty like oncology. And the way the kind of doctor I want to be is, I want to be a doctor that listens and just helps support a patient through like a long and difficult journey. Because sometimes I think you have to accept that you can't, like, no matter how much you try, you can do all you can, but there's only so much you can do.
Yeah.
And sometimes the only thing you can do is just be there and be present and listen. And I guess just be a support as that patient goes through their journey, sort of thing. But that's me personally. I know I have a lot of friends who are very much interested in like the chase of it and like the diagnostics and I guess acute medicine. And I think the great thing about medicine is like there's a different specialty for every personality. But for me, I think I like the long, I guess being like supporting a patient throughout like their journey, so.
And one question that's just popped into my mind as you say that. So you're interested in oncology, which is amazing, and it's a specialty with the research that's involved. You can make a big difference to people's lives, and it's, as you said, it's a long journey. So, but then how does the other end of it affect you? So knowing that actually people don't have good outcomes and they're not always successful, how do you think that will affect you?
I think you can't say, I think, unless you're there, but I can say this, and again, some of you might know if you like have seen my videos. So my uncle was diagnosed with glioblastoma before I came and did my master's. So even though I was kind of on like the peripheral side of his journey, because obviously he was in a different country, but I think I kind of made my peace with that. I feel like that made me mature a lot and like look at like the world and look at medicine differently. And I think you kind of get to a point where you, like, I look back and I just think, well, you know what, my family can rest easy thinking they did everything they could to support him, and ultimately that's all you can do. And it's never going to be easy, but that's just the way I look at it. And I think maybe because I've had this experience, I think you kind of have to put some of your expectations aside and think, oh, you know, you're going to be fine, like, don't worry about it. Although you might want to tell patients that, you have to kind of just deal with the realities.
I think that's quite a mature way of looking at it,
Yeah, I think so, because I think it's tough, isn't it? Like palliative care, oncology, some other like long chronic things, and sometimes the patients are young, which makes it harder.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I guess that is that. Sorry to end it on like a really depressing note.
Oh, I'm sorry about your uncle.
No, thank you, but It's okay. Just like putting the realities of that out there. Exactly. So
yeah, it's not all fun and games and pink and fluffy. Medicine,
but
yeah,
I'm sure
hard.
It can be. Can we finish it off on like a happy?
No,
I think you should say a happy, like something good, like something that I should look forward to.
No, definitely. So like, obviously there are those sides of things that you need to think of, but on the like the majority of medicine is all about patient satisfaction and people leave hospital healthy and appreciative.
Yes.
So and that is the part of medicine that keeps you going because.
Yeah.
It's just so rewarding when that happens. It sounds so cliche, but it's so true.
Yeah, no, totally, completely. Because you feel like you've done right by somebody. So, yeah.
Exactly. Well, thank you. That was such a nice chat.
Thank you.
Do you want to give us a small summary about your channel and what sort of things you do?
Yeah, so, I mean, I've been documenting my journey, like, towards medicine for 2 years. So if you just want to see me, like, have multiple breakdowns over, like, 2 application cycles and 24 months, be my guest. It has a happy ending, at least. and other than that, I think I just make like certain vlog videos. I make certain vlog videos like in the lab or just around London or study skills and that kind of stuff. Yeah, fun and games. Come and say hello.
Well, thank you for being part of my channel and being part of my video today. If you want to leave us any comments, then pop them in the the comment section below and we'll make sure that we reply back to them. Do subscribe to Atousa's channel as well if you want more of like the medicine side of the medical school that I was like way ahead of and didn't get to do. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'll see you guys in the next video.
Bye.